ए दगडू, त्या गणपतला घे पटकन, ओटी भरते, नाहीतर सगळं सामान आणि आपणही वाहून जाऊ या भरतीत.
said Baburao Tutar curiously. The high tide was nearing. The three men reached Kolwawadi, an island towards the west coast of the island of Salfit. A land sparsely occupied by houses, but lush green with fields of rice on the north in Gorai, scattered groves of mango, tamarind and cocoa. The coast was lined with tall green coconut trees with a foreground of occasionally grey rocks. Up banks and mangrove swamps towards the west edge as the land disappeared into the Arabian Sea. It was the month of September when the night tides were higher than the day. The mangroves that grew on the blue clay existed at about half tide mark, which had now begun to submerge because of the rising tide. They struggled to unload big parcels wrapped in pieces of black cloth. Turn by turn, they carried the parcels to a nearby shelter around the grazing land. A board reads, "Private property of Sutars, no trespassing." The shelter was made by Baburao himself, since he was a Sutar by profession. Dagdu wobbled his way getting the last piece to the tabela and heard footsteps approaching. Dagdu and Ganpat Mane were brothers that worked for Baburao. They were Luhars. In addition to labor work, they also helped him manage his affairs. Dagdu was clumsy and timid, but good at managing accounts, whereas Ganpat was the fearless village pehlwan who took on any challenge thrown at him. Dagdu dropped the last piece and ran towards the shelter, where Ganpat and Baburao were busy covering the pile of parcels with bundles of hay. A perfect disguise. Dagdu asked in shivers.
अरे सगळं सामान गेलं कुठे?
बाबूराव गेव हिम अ टॅपली ऑन हिज हेड.
अरे मंद, तू शेवटचा डब्बा कुठे विसरून आला?
स्टॅमरिंग इन शॉक, दगडू रिप्लाइड,
देख मला काहीतरी ऐकू आलं, कोणीतरी आपल्याला बघतय.
गप्प बस फाटऱ्या, कामाला लाग. आज रात्री जरा पण झोपायचं नाही, लक्ष द्या. ए गणपत, सांभाळ याला, जरा शिकव काही आणि सामानावर लक्ष द्या. मी उद्या पहाटे येईन. एकदा या जागेवर पोहोचलो की मग आपण उद्या निवांतपणे झोपू शकू.
The boat started tucking the pin that anchored it to the island. By now, the mangroves had subsequently sunk deep to allow the sea to wash completely over their roots and deposit sediment content over them.